sadhana means that, that you have set fire to yourself, you always burn. You're always the source of light, never in darkness. This is something you must earn, every one of you. So, being here for the 6-7 months, knowingly, unknowingly, you're soaked with this place, with this energy. You must see how it grows.
For me, it's been a very incubating period, to be very honest. Slowly after doing sadhana, I got a clarity. And with that clarity, I was able to be more still. I was balanced within in my thoughts and emotions. And that furthered my clarity. I'm really able to see that being still and doing nothing is the most profound and intense state that I have ever discovered in my life.
Silence is so beautiful. In my experience, whatever I am seeing or listening or touching or in whichever way I'm experiencing, that's heightened when I'm quiet. I don't know how that happens, but to be quiet is so beautiful.
I was thinking that just this silence just worked for me like a vacuum pump. I mean, it just sucked the anger out of me and kept it in front of me. And I could consciously see that this is my anger, but I was not affected by that anger. I was very angry, I was very intense in anger. But within half an hour, it just evaporated.
It's a very new experience to me because I always thought, like in the outside world, if you're unmoved by everything, that somehow was strength to me. But coming into Isha's space, now I'm seeing a leaf and crying. Now I'm seeing, you know, the wind just on my face and I'm crying. So, I can't probably explain what is it that I'm exactly feeling then, but it's a sense of inclusiveness I feel, you know. It's a sense of devotion to what's around me and the unknown of it.
Waking up at 3 a.m. and going to Suryakund every morning was such a buzz. It was amazing. Like, the way my practices, the way my muscles loosened up from being there, I absolutely loved it.
Shivanga sadhana, last year also I did, and this year also I'm doing. I can see a different level of emotion is being generated for Devi, a different connect, like more like mother-daughter connection I can see is forming between me and Devi.
Whether you call it Shiva, whether you call it Tao, whether you call it God or Source or whatever you call it, definitely this Shivanga sadhana opens you up to that.
Wherever you go, whatever you do, ensure one thing that you don't compromise is expansion of who you are. That you never compromise. Not for money, not for wealth, not for relationships, not for comfort. You never compromise the fire of sadhana, because that's vital. That's the only way you will live a life of fulfillment. Otherwise, you may live a life of comfort. You may live a life of approval from other people, but you will never know what it means to be just sit here. Even if I don't do anything, simply sitting here, you're fulfilled. This will come to you only when you start burning within yourself endlessly.